VIA Configurator is an online tool used to modify the firmware of various models of mechanical keyboards. I'm going to show you how to use VIA to customize the colors and background effects of a Keychron Q2 Max keyboard, but this should work for any QMK compatible keyboard. QMK stands for Quantum Mechanical Keyboard, but it's not a type of keyboard. It's open source firmware that many keyboard enthusiasts use. VIA, on the other hand, is a graphical user interface that's used to quickly and easily update the firmware of QMK compatible keyboards. It's not open source, however, and keyboard junkies have been keeping their eye on an alternative called Vial that is open source. It's not up to speed with VIA just yet, but it's definitely gaining popularity and something to keep your eyes on. In recent years, some popular keyboard manufacturers like Keychron, NuPhy, and KBDFans have begun shipping fully assembled keyboards already pre-installed with QMK firmware. There's a full list of QMK compatible keyboards on the QMK website, but as you can see, the list is quite long. It's best to just search the page or check with your keyboard manufacturer. To configure your keyboard backlighting with VIA, first plug your keyboard into your computer with a cable. Then go to usevia.app and click on the authorized device button. If your keyboard already has QMK firmware installed, you should see it in the list. Select it and connect. Now go to the VIA settings and toggle the switch to enable the design tab. Now click on the design tab that's appeared in the toolbar. For some keyboards, VIA will automatically detect the definition or firmware template to use when updating backlight effects. But for some keyboards, a JSON file must be uploaded first. For Keychron keyboards, go to keychron.com/pages/firmware. Find and click on your keyboard model, and then scroll down until you find the keymap JSON file. It might be a little bit down the page. Download it, unzip it, and then upload the JSON file to the design tab of VIA where we left off earlier. You'll have to find the JSON file for whatever model keyboard you're using if VIA doesn't already have it in its library. Now, it's time to have some fun. Click on the Configure tab, and then on the very left side of the screen, click on the light bulb symbol to access the backlight configuration. Don't get tripped up by the lighting option within the key mapping section. This is how you could change the default keyboard shortcuts for adjusting your keyboard lighting without using software, which for Keychron keyboards is totally possible, by the way. A link to these shortcuts is in the description, but you can, of course, just check them out here within VIA as well. Okay, so click on the actual light icon instead. From here on out, it's pretty simple. You can adjust the brightness using the bar, you can choose an effect, and the changes will be reflected immediately on your keyboard. I set my Q2 keyboard up with the typing heat map effect. I really love this one. It starts off when you're typing on the keyboard as a cool blue, and then the colors heat up as you type in that part of the keyboard more. Obviously, there's a lot more you can do with VIA. You can customize your entire keyboard, create macros, all sorts of stuff. But this should help you get connected, get the visuals set up, and help you understand how VIA, QMK, and your keyboard all link together. Before you leave, one last thing. I know that a lot of you haven't given your keyboards a good cleaning in quite some time. So if you want to know the absolute best way to clean a mechanical keyboard, don't forget to check out this video right here. If you found the video that you're watching right now helpful, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more videos related to keyboards and typing, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Good luck getting those backlights set up, everyone. I'm Anson Alexander, and I will see you in the next one.